I'm here. Come and see me, room 219A. A? Angela. Royal Plaza Hotel, New York. Oh, she was there. She was there. They were there together. They're having an affair, Kane and Angela. They're having an affair. Oh. I'm gonna kill him. I'm gonna kill him.
How you holding up?
Oh, well, honey, I'm doing a whole lot better now that I'm home and I'm out of the old jail cell.
Good. Then do me a favor. Just stay home.
Well, I was going to call you because I got a real good idea for the radio station.
No. Just forget about all of that because I think we'll probably play something from last month. You know, just steer clear of the station from now. For now.
Why? Bo, I didn't ask you for a raise, honey. I asked you why you didn't want me to go down there.
Somebody leaked your name to the media, and now we have protesters at WVL.
Protesters?
Yeah. From the Organization for a Strong America, that group.
Oh, come on. Those right-wingers, they show up every time thinking they can get on TV.
I know.
They just hold up their signs with a bunch of misspelled words.
Well, this time I think it's a little more serious. One of them threw a rock through a plate glass window. And they're calling you a murderer, Luna.
Feeling any better?
Here you go.
Barely. Well, I brought you something that should ease the pain.
Oh, thank you. I do hope they're strong because my head feels like it's being trampled by a herd of elephants. They should help. What I really need, though, isn't in pill form.
What's that?
I need somebody to tell me that Todd Manning is going to pull through and that Luna's going to get off.
Well, it's going to take a small miracle.
You've heard something.
The word on Todd isn't good. The doctors say he may not pull through.
Pal, not one more word,
man.
What are you doing?
Not one more word. Not to him, not to anybody.
Oh, hey, what are you doing here?
Exactly what it looks like. I'm here to stop Powell from shooting off his mouth.
Well, you don't worry about it. I yanked him off a plane. He's going to do what I say. We're going to the police. He's telling the truth. That Luna hit Todd out of self-defense. Isn't that right?
Powell. I'm warning you. Not another word, man.
What is this not another word stuff? Do you know something could help Luna? Answer me. Me. Did you see what happened to that alley? Were you there too?
Look, I don't know anything about that, okay? I'm just here to stop Powell from skipping bail.
He's not going anywhere. What do you care if he talks?
The less he says, the better.
Why, what are you afraid of?
I'm afraid of going to prison. You see, if Powell here admits that he's leaving the state, even to you, it could screw up our retrial. DA could have you testify, and what makes him look bad makes us all look bad. Now, you wouldn't want to mess up our retrial, would you, Powell?
No, I'm not buying this. What are you hiding?
Look, I'm not hiding anything from you, okay?
Look,
I swear, I told
you. Were you there when Marty was attacked by Todd? Did you see? If you saw something, you better say it now.
All I know is what everybody's saying is that Luna and Marty just attacked Todd for no reason at all.
That is a load of bull.
Oh, yeah? Well, Todd's about to die in the hospital right now. Is that a lot of bull?
Luna had no choice. Todd was attacking Marty.
Some people don't see it that way. And if Todd dies, then she murdered him. Right, pal? Right?
A murderer. That's what they're calling me, huh?
Look, don't let it get to you, Luna. They're a bunch of skinheads. You're a woman who fought back. Okay? So don't go near the station right now. We're gonna give them all the space they want. They can march around and, until they tire out. And knowing them, that's not gonna take that long.
Maybe part of me agrees with them.
Luna.
I have never felt such rage when I hit Todd. Maybe I hit him because I wanted to get him back for what he did to Marty and Carol Swift and God knows what other woman out there.
Yeah, the only reason that you hit him is to save Marty. If you hadn't done that, he would have raped her again.
I have never felt that kind of rage.
That guy is an animal. You did what you had to do, okay? And the only thing that these protesters were all fired out about is you believe a woman should fight back. You gonna give in to them?
No.
No, then stop talking about this is all your fault, okay? You have so many people behind you, your family, your friends, everybody you work with down at WVL.
I wish I didn't have to deal with those OSA crazies.
Don't worry, don't worry. I talked to Hank. He's going to have the police department take care of them. Right now, we're going to concentrate on protecting you.
I'm going to be fine.
Luna, this is very serious business. Believe me, you have to watch your back. Now, who was that was driving away when I pulled up? Were they hassling you?
Oh, no, Sugar. That was Marty and Sway checking up on me.
Has anybody else been up here?
Just my brother, Ty. Oh, maybe that's Max calling to... Maybe he found Powell or something at the airport. Hey, honey, what's happening?
Got a message from Miss Luna, man-hater Moody. She thinks she's so tough. Get ready to die.
What are you doing here, my fiancé's, Angela?
Obviously, I'm here to see Kane.
Why? Did you come to give him his divorce?
No. That's wishful thinking, I'm afraid. As I told you, my religious beliefs make that impossible.
Yes, right. You did tell me that.
It's not my will that is important. It is the Lord's.
No.
I am sympathetic to you. I know you must be feeling terribly frustrated.
If you have something to say, Angela, just say it.
You know, there is one little thing I don't understand. When the divorce goes through, won't it be a little awkward for you and Kane to get married if Court still thinks that you're married to him?
I don't think that's any of your business.
Ah. Well, unless, of course, Court gets his memory back. But then that would be awkward because he would remember that you were engaged to a man while he was stuck in that prison camp. That's very sad.
How fortunate for you that you don't have to worry about this, Angela, because like I said, it's none of your business.
That may be. But it still sounds like you have one too many men on your hands. Look. I just came here to return Kane's sweater.
Excuse me?
Well, we ran into each other the other night when we were walking, and, well, I had a little chill.
Since when does Kane go out walking?
Well, I guess he's picked up a new habit. Anyway, I only came here to return it.
Angela, did you call here earlier and hang up?
No. Why? Is there a problem?
Yeah, there's a problem. And I think it's you.
Me?
Yes, Angela, and I have a question for you, and I really want you to answer me honestly, for once. Can you do that? Or is everything about you as fake as your hair?
Okay?
Yeah, no, I feel fine. I can feel the pill starting to work.
Do you know how the migraines came on this time?
Oh, I don't know. I was in the middle of a run-in with good old Peter Manning.
Him. You know, I don't know who's worse, Todd or his father.
Oh, it's definitely a toss-up.
Ah.
Yeah. I was lucky, though. Beau came along just in time and told him off. Hmm.
And the migraines came on when? During the argument or after?
Oh, I don't really remember when they come on. I was very aware of it after Beau left. It was sort of the vice grip on either side of the head, and then someone taking two identical knives and plunging them deep into the eye socket, turning them ever so slightly, giving it that very memorable sensation.
Ah, yes, it sounds like it.
I closed my eyes, and when I opened them, I was sitting in a chair across the hallway.
You didn't remember how you got there?
No. That's a blackout, isn't it?
Could be. Has this ever happened to you before?
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, a few times, probably more than I'm willing to admit.
Or able to remember.
Well, I remember one time it happened with Rachel. I don't know how long it lasted, but it was pretty scary.
Yeah. Well, Nora, I mean, come on. You've been through a lot. The mistrial, the rape case, going up in front of the disciplinary board, and now this tragedy with Luna.
It's just never a dull moment.
Maybe you should take some time away from all this pressure and stuff.
Yeah, maybe.
Right now, I think you should get your rest and call Larry Wallach in the morning.
Call it Larry?
Nora,
it's tension.
Nora,
all
it
could
be anything. And who knows? Except for a doctor. Now, I think you should go see him. Better safe than sorry, right?
Mrs. Lord?
Young lady, would you please stop following me?
The public wants to know, Mrs. Lord.
Hello, Wanda. I'll seat myself.
Sloan Carpenter book implies that you were responsible for Victor Lord's death. Would you care to comment?
What paper are you with?
The Chronicle.
All right. I've got an exclusive for you. I intend to sue any rag that prints a word of that lie. And the reporter who writes it. Do you understand me? Good. Now get away from me.
Thank you.
What happened to the press being the last bastion of truth? What are you doing in here?
Looking for someone. Do you mind?
Yes, I do mind. I don't want you to have anything more to do with Jason, okay? No more fancy presents for him. Now, he has finally come to his senses, and I do not want you trying to bribe your way back into his life.
I did not, for your information, come here to see your precious nephew. In fact,
I don't care if I ever see him again. Then who?
Angela Holliday, if it's any business of yours.
Oh, I should have known. Only that sweet, innocent child would still have faith in a person like you. The only problem that that girl has got, she's too naive.
Tina, I really don't understand your hostility. Have I done something to you?
Stop it.
Angela, I just want the truth.
I have never been anything but truthful.
Oh, right, right. So tell me, last night, were you in New York City and did you stay at the Royal Plaza Hotel?
No. I haven't left Landview in months.
You haven't? Are you sure?
I think I would remember if I saw the bright lights of New York City. I've never even heard of the Royal Plaza Hotel. Tina, you know me. I'm just a country girl.
You're right, Angela. I do know you.
Look, will you just tell Kane that I returned his sweater?
You bet.
Thank you. You know, I hope I'm not overstepping my bounds, but could I just give you one little piece of advice? It's been my experience that trust breeds more trust and more love. And distrust only breeds unhappiness. Lord knows there's enough unhappiness in the world, Tina. Please, will you think about that?
Trust breeds more trust. We'll just see about that. Same perfume.
Royal Plaza Hotel. Kane, I am definitely going to kill you.
See you later. Hey, Charlie, aren't you working dispatch tonight?
Yeah, Joe, but I got one more pickup to make first.
I know that's her lipstick. Oh, Kane, how could you do this to me after everything we have been through?
Hey, Tina. Glad you're still here. That manager had me trapped in her office. I got your wallet here. You didn't have to tear the room apart, honey.
Don't you dare call me honey.
What the hell was that about?
What the hell was that about? You know what that was about, you two-chiming jerk.
What?
Kane, you're cheating on me with Angela.
All right, come on, let's go.
Wait, where do you think you're going
with that? I'm going back to Landview. I'm taking him home.
No, you're not. I told you, he's going straight to the police with me.
Oh, what, so we can get us all into more trouble? Is that it?
Since when do you make decisions for him?
He doesn't. Not anymore.
Powell.
Wait for me, Zach.
Powell, calm down, okay? I'm just trying to help you.
I don't want your help!
Look, we're in this together.
No, we're not!
You can just listen to me and give me a chance.
No.
You would see that everything's gonna be okay.
Not gonna be the same, all right? You're driving me crazy. I can't take it anymore. I can't take it.
Who is this? Answer me.
If Todd Manning dies, my friends and I are going to see to it you fry.
Oh, my goddess.
Give me the phone. Who is this? Hey, come on, why don't you say something now, you coward? Help. Hello.
He said I should get ready to die.
No, listen to me. Listen to me, Luna. Somebody calls like that on the phone and they make a threat at you, that's because they don't have the guts to look you in the eye. They never come through. Do you understand that?
It's real scary.
I know. Well, I'm going to call Hank right now and get protection for you immediately. We're not going to let these guys get anywhere near you.
Bo, wait. Don't.
Why not?
I need you to take me somewhere.
Now?
Yes.
Luna, look. This is very dangerous, okay? These people are nuts.
I need you to take me to the hospital.
The hospital? Why? What's wrong?
I need to see Todd Manning. Now.
No woman talks to me like that. Get you. Teach you a lesson.
Come, Hector, I will make you lunch.
Because Hector Boyardee always had to wait for his favorite foods.
Good food takes time.
He grew up to become Chef Boyardee.
Look, I don't have anything to say to you.
Good, then you can listen. I know you and your frat buddies raped Marty. I don't need a jury to tell me that.
Look, I also know that Todd tried to rape Marty again last night in the alley. If he survives, he can thank God that it was Luna that hit him. Because if I was there in the alley, he'd already be dead. Is that clear? Is it clear?
Yes.
Good. Now we're getting somewhere.
Are you done?
No, not quite. I will be done when these bogus charges against Luna are dropped. And they will be dropped because I'm going to see to it. And I'm going to use whatever means necessary. Now, right now, I need your friend, Powell. Now, are you going to stand in my way, huh? I asked you a question.
No.
Good answer. You make me sick, you little weasel. Now get out of here.
I didn't do anything to your girlfriend.
I know. So take it easy.
What do you want from me?
I want you to help get Luna out of trouble. You know she's innocent.
When's it all gonna end?
You can end it right now, pal, by telling the truth about Luna, about everybody. Listen, you made some mistakes. But it's time to stop running away from them.
Everything got screwed up when I came to Landview. I want out.
Now, the problem is not about being in Landview. The problem is in your head. It's your conscience that's starting to eat at you. Now, are you gonna help Luna or not?
Finally, in local news, Landview authorities released Darlene Luna Moody on bail this morning.
What?
The well-known Loveline talk show host and part owner of Serenity Springs Spa stands accused of aggravated assault. Todd Manning, the victim, is still in intensive care at...
Oh, poor Luna.
There you are. I have been looking all over for you.
Well, you know me. Busy doing the Lord's work.
Oh, you're smiling again. Things are going better with Kane.
Well, let's just say that part one of the plan is off and running. Thank you for your help.
Oh, marvelous. You took my advice. Convinced Tina that you and Kane are...
Yes, and it seems that Tina's fallen pretty badly.
Oh, she's such a bimbo. She'd believe anything.
Well, I see while I was out working, you were busy shopping.
Yes, well, everything I do has a purpose and a price. Now, my price for helping you with Kane is that you are going to help me with Kathy. Understood?
Understood.
I do you a favor, you do a favor for me in return.
Fair enough. I will get started on those press releases about all your charity donations.
No, forget about those. Really, I'm going to stop trying to be good. I've done that act, and where's it landed me? Well, my life is a wreck, truly. And we both know who is responsible. Well, now it is going to be Sloane Carpenter's turn.
Just exactly what do you intend to do?
I want to see him suffer. I mean, suffer badly for writing those lies about me. He has ruined my reputation, and now I am going to destroy his. And you, my dear, are going to help me figure out how to do it.
I am?
Yes. And in return, I am going to give you an idea for phase two of Operation Breakup, Tina and Kane. In fact, I even bought something for the plan. Yeah. Would you like to see your present?
I don't ever want to see you again.
Wait.
You really broke my heart.
Wait a minute, Tina. I'm not having an affair with Angela.
Stop it. I don't want to hear your lies.
I'm not lying, Tina. Honey, I love you, all right? I don't care about Angela. I don't want anything to do with her.
Oh, so you're just sleeping with her for the fun of it? Is that what you're telling me?
No, we have not slept together since we were married.
But you are married now!
Tina, you know what I mean. All right? What in the world makes you think that I'm sleeping with Angela?
This.
A sweater?
Soaked with perfume. Was Angela with you at the Royal Plaza Hotel in New York last night, Kane? Is that when you loaned her the sweater?
Come on, I love Tina, Angela. I'm not going to be unfaithful to her.
Answer me. Was Angela in New York?
Tina, I knew it. No, Tina, you're wrong, all right? That's not even my sweater. I've never seen it before.
Why should I believe you?
Because I would never lie to you about something like this.
Oh, right, but you would lie to me about something else, right?
Oh, come on, that is not fair. Tina, I've been completely faithful. Now, how about you?
How about me?
Well, you're pretending like you're married to Cord. Have you been sleeping with him?
I have told you a million times that I am not sleeping with Cord. You know that the only reason I am with him is because of CJ and Sarah. If I told him that I was with you, then it would just make him have a nervous breakdown, and I don't want to do that to my kids. Is that what you want?
No, honey. You know I love those kids, too.
Then stop questioning me all the time. Besides, it's not about me. It's about you. You and Angela.
Well, I'm not sleeping with Angela.
Then what are you doing with her? If you love me, Kane, then I deserve to know the truth. This is your last chance, Kane. You tell me the truth or I'm going to walk out that door, and the minute that door slams, you're not going to have a chance to come into my heart because I will be gone for good.
they gonna tell me the truth or not?
Wait, Tina. Tina, wait. Okay. Okay. The truth. Tina, just sit down, okay?
I don't want to sit down. Just tell me, Kane. If you're not having an affair with Angela, what are you doing with her? What is she doing here at all hours of the day and night? What is going on?
I can't believe this. Tina, I didn't want you to know about this. I didn't want you to find out about it this way.
Tell me, Kane, or else I'll leave it.
Okay. Hey, Angela has forced me into doing some cons with her.
You mean you're back doing?
I didn't want to do it, Tina.
She forced you.
Yes.
Would she hold a gun to your head, Kane? How can she force you to do anything? Oh, unless you find it impossible to say no to that woman.
No, Tina, she had... Look, I needed the money.
You needed the... Right. Right. Yeah. Your manager said you couldn't pay the bill, and now you say you need the money. What's going on, Kane? You didn't get your paychecks?
Well, it's a little more complicated than that.
Oh, but you were doing so well. Igo Insurance didn't fire you, did they?
Not exactly.
So you're still working for Mr. Igo?
Not exactly.
Well, you're either working for him or you're not.
I'm not.
Were you ever?
No.
So this is all a lie.
Tina, look, you know, I almost had the job, okay? But Angela crashed the interview and she sabotaged the whole thing.
So? Why didn't you tell me that? What?
Because you were pressuring me to get a job.
Oh, right. It's my fault.
Look, honey, I just didn't want to lose you, all right?
I don't understand, Kane. This doesn't explain why you're doing cons now.
Okay. Angela's blackmailing me.
With what?
Some letters I wrote her a long time ago, before I ever met you, Tina.
What's so special about these letters?
Well, they're very incriminating letters. About some cons I pulled with women. Stuff I'm not very proud of, Tina. I mean, it was bad. I just didn't want you to know how bad I was, that's all.
So how bad were you?
It was bad enough that if the cops found out, I'd be in a lot of trouble.
So you teamed up with Angela? And you two together are running cons so that you could stop me from knowing about some letters that you wrote years ago.
Did some really bad things, Tina.
Haven't I forgiven you for every illegal thing that you've done so far? Haven't I accepted all of your faults and loved you? You know why, Kane? Because I believed you had changed. But you haven't, have you? You're just exactly the same. You're a liar.
Honey, come on now. I didn't have a choice, baby.
like that where Angela really has this whole stack full of passionate love letters from you written very recently.
No, Tina, that's not what they are.
You know, you're such a hypocrite, too, because all this time you've been accusing me of sleeping with my husband when you've been sleeping with your wife.
Look, I'm not sleeping with Angela.
Oh, Kane, I'm not that dumb. Oh, unless you started wearing perfume and lipstick, huh?
What are you talking about, Tina?
Isn't this yours?
Ty, is Luna okay? All right, tell her that I love her and that she should hang in there. And if anybody could get her proved innocent, you know it's gonna be Max. Okay, and you tell her that I'm gonna send a care package over right away.
Oh, it's beautiful. Look.
Ty, I gotta go. This sweet angel is being lured by a devil in dyed hair.
Are you kidding? I love it. I love it.
Oh, good. But now let's get down to business.
Yo-ho!
Angela!
Angela!
Oh, that woman's voice really is annoying. She's starting to get on my nerves.
Shh.
Yes, Wanda?
Could I see you for 1 minute, please?
Oh, certainly. Could you excuse me for a minute?
Make it fast.
Is everything okay?
You know that you are one of my favorite people, right? And I wish that everybody in this whole restaurant could be more like you, could be wonderful.
Thank you.
But there are certain people that come in here that are not wonderful, like that Dorian. And I would like to warn you, please stay away from her. She is very, very dangerous.
Why do you say that?
You remember I told you about my nephew and that he was all ensnared in this awful web with an older woman.
Really?
And she was always giving him expensive presents, just like I see she's trying to give to you. Look at her. She's a viper with a fat wallet. Look, I know that your work is good work, and you know that I believe in your work. And if ever you need, if you need money, all you have to do is ask me. Look, I know that it's not a lot of money, but please take it. Just stay away from her.
Wanda, you have already given me far too much.
You just consider it a loan.
Wanda, you were very kind, but you were forgetting something. The Lord sent me to Landview to save not the good, but the fallen.
You just take care of yourself. Promise me.
Don't worry. I can take care of myself.
What, so you think I should call a doctor again? See another doctor?
Yes, it can't hurt.
Oh, no?
No.
I'm getting a headache just thinking about it.
Hey, guys.
Hey, you're back.
Hi.
How are you,
honey? Oh, I'm doing just fine.
She is holding up like a champ.
Of course she is. Did Max find Paul?
I don't know.
We had heard from him since he left for the airport.
We did get a phone call from somebody else.
Why are you looking like that? Well, who was the phone call from?
It was an anonymous death threat for Luna.
What? Well, do that.
Don't worry about it. It's just Bo said that the Organization for Strong American People are picking it at the station.
Skinheads?
Wow. Did you tell Frank?
About the pickers, but not about the call.
Well, I'll take care of that. It was time we started taking some precautions. I'll see you later.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
So what are you two doing here anyway? I mean, wouldn't it be safer at home?
That's what I said.
Well, I was climbing the walls, and I thought maybe I could get a rundown on how Todd's doing.
Well, you just missed the doctor.
Is there any change?
He's still in critical condition. I mean, he's been stable for the last couple of hours. They want to keep him in intensive care for the time being.
Well, that's fairly positive, don't you think?
Oh, yeah, that makes me feel much better. I think I can relax now. I'm gonna run down to the cafeteria, get me something to eat. I'll see y'all.
See ya.
Thank you.
You gonna tell me this isn't your handkerchief either, huh?
Yes, that's my handkerchief, Jan, but I don't know how perfume got on it. I don't even know whose perfume that is.
Oh, smell it. Smell familiar? How about Eau d'Evangelist?
Well, I think I'm beginning to smell a skunk.
Yeah, well, I think I'm standing in the same room as one.
Look, that's not true, Tina. Look, Angela and I have not slept together.
What about this lipstick?
I don't know. I mean, isn't it yours?
No, it's not mine. I would never wear this color.
Well, then it's the maids or the managers. I mean, she's always in here bugging me about the rent. I don't know, Tina.
Right. Yeah, the manager comes in here and you don't have money, so you toast over your debts with champagne. Come on, Kane, you're a con artist. Can't you think of a better excuse than that?
This is just as much a shock to me as it is to you.
I hope your partner is a better liar than you are.
I'm not lying, Tina.
I don't believe you came because I know whose lipstick it is, and I know whose perfume it is. It's Angela's.
Now, whatever happened to trusting me?
I did trust you, Kate. I trust you when you said that you weren't gonna pull any more cons. I trusted you when you said you had a job. I trusted you when you said you were divorced from Angela. I trusted you when you told me you loved me. I'm not gonna trust you again. As far as marriage is concerned, here, why don't you propose to your wife?
Tina, come, wait.
Listen, pal, I know you've been going through hell lately. And I understand if you don't want to answer my questions.
Good.
So let's just talk. I'm not going to hurt you. I'm not going to make you do anything you don't want to do.
Okay?
Look, right now, you're probably thinking that no one can understand what you're going through. I just want you to know that I did a lot of really nasty things in my past that I'm ashamed of. And my conscience got to me the same way yours is getting to you.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, yeah, you do. It's pretty obvious you're all torn up about what you did to Marty.
You didn't do anything to her.
Yeah, whatever you say. You and I both know what really happened.
Stop.
I don't want to talk about that.
You don't want to talk about it. It's okay, because what happened is between you and Marty and your conscience. I'm just trying to show you a way to ease the guilt by helping Luna.
I can't help her.
Yes, you can. But tell them the truth about what happened in that alley. Pal, you don't know Luna the way I do. They don't come as good as her. She would never do anything to hurt anyone. The only way she would ever hit Todd is to save Marty. She had no other choice. Isn't that the way it happened?
I don't know.
Powell, this is your chance to do the right thing. Chance to start making up for the mistakes you've made. Now, all I'm asking you to do is help yourself by helping Luna.
Todd, I know I'm probably the last person you want to see, but I had to come by here. Ever since last night, ever since I hit you, I hadn't been able to eat or sleep. I'm I'm all torn up inside. And I figured I had to come by here. I gotta ask you something. Can you forgive me, Todd? I don't know if you will or not, but I know I won't ever feel right if I don't ask, so. So there, I asked. One day, you know, you gotta ask Marty for her forgiveness too, or you won't ever feel right about yourself again. That's something that you're gonna have to face. So you get well, don't die on me, because I want you to be able to face all those demons inside you, and I want you to grow up to be a good man. I'm gonna pray for that.
Steady now.